Welcome back. I shouldn't try to squeeze in videos because then I rush and then you won't learn and everything breaks down. So problem number 7. A, B, and C are different positive integers, and 2 to the A times 2 to the B times 2 to the C is equal to 64. And they want to know what is 2 to the A plus 2 to the B plus 2 to the C. Well, here we can just two things we can use. We can use our exponent rules where we can, if we have the same base and we multiply it, we can just add the exponents, right? So this is equal to 2 to the A plus B plus C. And then can we write 64 as a power of 2? Yeah, sure. Let's see. 2 to the third is equal to 8. And 64 is 8 squared. So if we square both sides of that, so that's 2 to the 6th. And you might already know that. 2 to the 6th is 64. 2 to the 6th. Right? And you could think, 2 to the 5th is 32, 2 to the 6th is 64, of course. So A plus B plus C has to equal 6. A plus B plus C is equal to 6. And what do they tell us? A, B, and C are different positive integers. They're different positive integers. So what are A, B, and C? Well, let's see. They could be 1, 2, and 3, right? Because 1 plus 2 plus 3 is equal to 6. All right? So there we have it. A, B, and C are 1, 2, and 3. So 2 to the A plus 2 to the B plus 2 to the C is the same thing as 2 to the 1 plus 2 squared plus 2 cubed. And that's equal to 2 plus 4 plus 8. 6 plus 8 is equal to 14. And that is choice A. Next problem. I'll switch colors for variety. Problem number 8. In the xy plane, the center of a circle has the coordinates 3, comma, minus 7. Let's see if I have to draw this. If one endpoint of a diameter of the circle is minus 2, comma, 7, so this is the endpoint of the diameter. This is center. What of the coordinates of the other endpoint of this diameter? Well, sure, maybe I'll draw it for you. So, just so you get a sense. So, all of this action is going on, and so that's the. And then, see, the center is 3, comma, negative 7. So, if this is 3, let me do it in a more different color. 3 minus 7. So, this is the center. And this one diameter is at negative 2, 7. So this one diameter is at negative 2, 7. Negative 2, minus 2, and then 7. Positive 7. Actually, I drew this too big. So this is one endpoint. So actually, the circle is going to be huge. It's going to be, actually, let me redraw this, because this is going to be a huge circle. I didn't do this appropriately. So let me, if this is the coordinate axes, I'm going to draw it big like this. So the center, I'll now do it in a different color. The center is at 3, and then minus 7, right? And then one endpoint is at minus 2. Is it minus 2? Oh, no, you know what? I misread the problem. The other endpoint is at minus 2, minus 7. So the other endpoint is here. Minus 2, minus 7. So it's like here. Sorry, I could use this graph. So the other endpoint is minus 2, minus 7. Shows you how important it is to read these problems properly, right? So if you drew the circle actually looks something like this. Whoops. Right. But the important thing to realize, and you actually didn't even have to draw this circle, is that this diameter, this is the diameter that they're talking about. And I know I'm drawing it kind of funny. But this is the point right here, 3 minus 7. This is minus 2 minus 7. So to go from this point to this point, we didn't change our y coordinates, right? We just changed x. And what did we do? We went how far back? We went from x equals 3 to x equals minus 2. So we went 5 back, right? So the other endpoint of the diameter, we just have to go 5 in this direction. So if we start at x equals 3, we're going to end up at x equals 8. And then the y is going to stay the same because we're moving horizontally. So it's 8, negative 7. And that is choice E. Sorry for misreading it at first, but that shows it can happen to the best of us. No, just kidding. I'm not even the best of us. All right, next problem. 9. A regulation for riding a certain amusement park ride requires that a child be between 30 inches and 50 inches tall. So between 30, so height has to be greater than 30 and less than 50 inches tall. Fair enough. Which of the following inequalities can be used to determine whether or not a child's height satisfies the regulation for this ride? Okay, so they are essentially just rewriting this equation as saying as absolute value. And a number line could probably be useful here. So if I say, that's my number line, this is 30, and this is 50. We know, just from this inequality, that you know my height can be anywhere around here. And whenever I see these absolute value problems, they're really kind of picking kind of a median, or the middle point between the two. And they're using the absolute value to say, well, my distance away from that middle point can't be more than a certain amount. So what you can do is you can pick the middle point. If you want to convert this into an absolute value equation, you pick the middle point. So what's the middle point? 30 plus 50 is 80. The middle point is 40, right? I should have been able to do that in my head because it's 10 away from each other. And so we can say, instead of saying that the height has to be greater than 30 or the height has to be less than 50, we could say that the difference between the height and 40 and its absolute value, right? We don't care if the height is less than 40 or greater than 40, but that absolute value, that absolute distance between the height and 40 can't be more than what? Well, we can't go more than 10 to the positive, and we can't go more than 10 to the negative, right? So the absolute value has to be less than 10. That's how you should convert it. If you wanted to convert this to absolute value, and how they tend to do on the SAT, pick the average point, and then figure out how far can you vary from the average, right? The average point was 40, and you can vary at most 10. So the difference between the height and 40 has to be less than 10. This could have also been written as 40 minus h is less than 10. But the choice h minus 40 is less than 10, and that is choice D. Problem 10. A right circular cylinder with radius 5 and height 4 has volume V. In terms of V, So a right circular cylinder. So it looks like this. That's the base. That's the top of it. See, this is the top of the cylinder. And then I have, you know, a line like that. Then I have a line like that. And what are they telling us? They're telling us it's radius 5, so this distance is 5, radius 5, height 4, so height is 4, and the volume is V. Right, so the radius, okay, so the volume is V. So what is V equal? So V is equal to, you just have to figure out the area of this base. Actually, I have a minute left, so I'm going to do problem number 10 in the next video, so it's